Good morning, students. Once again, welcome to the class T Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering. So let us continue with our syllabus structure. I, Professor Dr. R. B. Dharekar, will continue with the subject Electromagnetic Field Theory. And let us start with the basic chapter, Coordinate System. So here, first of all, let us have an introduction to the syllabus structure that we have to continue. Here we can observe that as per the semester pattern, for this semester 5, there are 6 different subjects that we have to learn, starting from electromagnetic field theory, control system engineering, computer architecture, digital signal processing, microcontroller and applications, and one elective subject. Probably it will be probability theory, or we are trying to have one technical subject instead of that. In parallel, we have to continue with a few laboratory experiments of control system engineering, digital signal processing, and microcontroller and its application lab. As per the last semester, here we have to continue with one mini project, as well as we have to appear for a seminar. At the end of semester, definitely there will be field training that we have to attempt or that we have to complete. So here, let us start with the course objective of the subject. We can observe that for every subject, there are a few course objective as well as outcome designed for the subject that can be seen over here. So before starting of the subject, we have to understand what are the course objective for this subject, as well as what are the course outcome. These course objective as well as course outcome are made available on the internet in the Google Classroom. They are available in your syllabus copy. All of you people can observe or can have a look on the course objective as well as course outcome. Intention is that what are the requirements that are to be completed before starting of this subject, and what is expected by every student to learn for after completion of this subject that can be observed effectively, so that we can learn or we can have a look from where we have to start and where we have to reach. So it is a syllabus structure. Pay attention carefully. There are a few chapters headed with Maxwell's equation, uniform plane waves, transmission lines, plane wave at a media interface, wave propagation, and radiation. So all the subjects syllabus is to be completed. And all of you people are blessed with one new innovative parameter, that the overall syllabus structure is made available by NPTEL course before few years. Dr. Shiv Gaukar have presented a very efficient or effective lecture routines, and the syllabus structure that is drafted by our university is nothing but the syllabus of this online course. Here we can observe that starting from introduction to electromagnetic wave, transmission line, Maxwell's equation, uniform plane waves at media interface, waveguides and antenna, the exact syllabus is reflected in our syllabus provided by university. So friends, let us thank Dr. Shiv Gaukar for making available all these lectures for the successful routine of we all to become a practical engineer in the field of microwave engineering or in the field of electromagnetic engineering. So each and every student, instead of reading a number of reference books, can have access to these NPTEL videos directly by typing the link nptel.ac.in, and in the course we can provide the related information, or also we can type NPTEL Shiv Gaukar electromagnetic fields, and again we can continue with the lecture routine provided. So if you are going to listen or if you are going to understand one lecture per day with the help of your mobile phone, with the help of your headphones, it will be sufficient to complete with this course satisfactorily. Along with that, our regular lecture routine also will be the added benefit. So here we have to continue with the syllabus structure, and let us start with the coordinate system. Friends, till date we have learned that there is only one coordinate system that we were knowing, is nothing but Cartesian coordinate system, in which a point P can be located with the help of x-axis, y-axis, z-axis. Now we have to understand that instead of or along with Cartesian coordinate systems, there are a number of coordinate systems, like cylindrical coordinate system is there, spherical coordinate system is there, and along with that, there is a coordinate system in which we can provide the longitude and latitude so as to locate a particular point on the universe. Out of these number of coordinate system, here we have to practice with Cartesian coordinate system, cylindrical coordinate system, and spherical coordinate system. Friends, we have to understand here that instead of x, y, and z axis, here we can observe that there is radius of cylinder defined by r, there is angle made by an imaginary plane with positive x axis is phi, and z axis or z coordinate will be maintained as it is. Therefore, any point in cylindrical coordinate system will be having three parameters. One will be r, second will be phi, and third will be z. In the similar way, here we can observe in case of spherical coordinate system, there are again three parameters. One is nothing but the radius of sphere. Second is the angle made by an imaginary plane with positive x-axis, that is denoted by phi. And third coordinate is nothing but the angle made by a cone with positive z-axis. So all these three parameters will be constituting every point in the spherical coordinate system. So friend, before continuing with the further slides, we have to understand the conversion from curved length into linear. From the first pink type of triangle or pink color triangle, we can observe, if suppose pink arrow is indicating x, so what will be the value of x, which will be dependent on this value of phi? It is not required, we can say, or it is not possible to provide any specific relation, but as per your previous mathematical knowledge, we can observe that if there is a triangular shape which is having one curved portion, if the angle made by the two lines is phi, and if suppose we have to find out the curved length, we can write r into phi. If suppose y is the curved parameter, we can write r into phi, where r is the radius of this circular arc. In a similar way, we can see that if suppose the horizontal distance is suppose r sine theta, then blue colored arrow, if it is denoted by z, we can write z will be equal to r sine theta as this distance multiplied by the angle. In a brief way or in a simple way, we can write or we can say that to convert a curved distance into linear one, the provision to be done is that we have to multiply the angle of curvature by the radius value so as to get the effective value required. So now let us continue with the basics of our syllabus structure. All of you people are knowing differentiation and integration can be considered to be a very important tools for understanding the technical parameters at the higher level or at the higher depth. So friends, here till date we were knowing that if suppose we have to locate a length AB along x-axis, we can write x2 minus x1. In the same way, if suppose it is along y-axis, we can write it as y2 minus y1. And similarly, if it could be along z-axis, we could write z2 minus z1. Instead of that, in the technical routine, we have to write that length AB is equal to integration dx with the limits x1 to x2. Or if it is along y-axis, we can write length AB is equal to integration dy from y1 to y2. And if suppose it is along z-axis, we can write it as integration dz with the limits z1 to z2. If suppose instead of length, we have to calculate area, definitely all the students are knowing from the previous mathematical knowledge that if we have to calculate the area, we will have to consider double integration. If surface is along xy plane, we will have to write integration, double integration dx dy. If it is along yz plane, we can write double integration dy dz. If the surface is along xz plane, we can write in double integration dx dz. Last but not least, for the volume consideration, we can write triple integration of dx, dy and dz. So let us continue further. All of you people have worked a lot on calculation or on solving a number of examples on circle. So friends, we know that circumference of circle is given by 2 pi r, area of circle is given by pi r square, and the volume of sphere is given by 4 by 3 pi r cube. Now it is our job, or it is our practice, to find out by which relation the circumference will be related to 2 pi r, by which calculation or by which derivation area of circle is defined by pi r square, and how does volume of sphere can be given by 4 by 3 pi r cube. So let us consider here, if suppose there is a circle whose circumference is to be calculated, we can observe here that for measuring the length, there will be single integration. For consideration of the overall angle, which is nothing but 0 to 360 degree, can be calibrated by or can be considered as 0 to 2 pi. As per the last slide, we have to consider if the length is curved one, we have to consider by multiplication by the radius value. So instead of writing the overall angle d phi, will multiply it by r d phi, and the limits of integration will be starting from 0 to 2 pi. If we'll keep this r as it is and we'll solve the integration, we can write integration d phi will be 2 pi minus 0, because 2 pi will be upper limit and 0 will be lower limit. 2 pi minus 0 will be giving out the value 2 pi multiplied by the value of r, which will be giving the relation circumference of any circle can be described by the equation 2 pi r. Similarly, to calculate with the area of circle, we have to consider two dimensions. Therefore, we have considered here double integration. One variable is nothing but r, because there are n number of radii value for each and every point inside the circle. Therefore, we have considered here dr. And as per the above integration, to consider the length parameter, we have to consider r d phi. Separating the double integration into two different integration, we will be getting r dr into d phi. R dr will be getting integrated to r square by 2, and integration d phi will be giving us the value 2 pi. Therefore, 2 will be getting cancelled. Area of circle can be defined as equation with the equation pi r square. Similarly, volume of sphere can be described by triple integration, which is consisting of dr, d phi and d theta. as there is a spherical coordinate system under consideration, we'll have to consider for volume all the three parameters, that is dr value, that is d phi value, as well as the d theta value. As we know that wherever we have to use d theta, we'll have to use r d theta. Wherever in integration we are going to use d phi, we'll have to use r sine theta d phi. The mathematical background for using these values can be cleared in a few of the further lectures. So here, separating the integration, we can write r into r is nothing but r square dr. D phi can be separated, and sine theta d theta can be considered as a part of third integral value. By substituting the integration values, as a radius value is of different number of values, which can be considered in general at 0 to r range. Phi, as the previous one, will be having value 0 to 2 pi, and the angle made by the cone will be having 0 to 2 pi range. Therefore, substituting all, we'll be getting r square dr integrated to r cube by 3. Integration d phi will be giving out to be 2 pi, and integration sine theta d theta will be having value 2. Lastly, we can get the equation volume of sphere is nothing but 4 by 3 pi r cube. So this all is related to the basic introduction to the subject. A number of examples can be solved using this mathematical background so that we can reach to the actual syllabus structure. So have a look on the exercise on the practice time. I think maximum or about all the students have practiced to solve, or they have used these formulae. Area of rectangle is given by length into breadth. Now it is the question, why it is length into breadth only? What is the background behind this formula? Similarly, we have solved the volume of cylinder by using the formula pi r square h. From where this formula came into existence? Similarly, surface area of sphere can be given by 4 pi r square. Now it is a time to find out by which mathematical manipulation we can get this result. The same way, volume of a cube is given by third power of the length. In the same way, core surface area of a cylinder is given by 2 pi r h. All the parameters are to be found out by the requisite integration. We have to think over the issue that where we have to use single integral, double integral, or triple integral, so that the further lecture will be having a maximum numerical aspect, which can be effective if we are practicing these basic parameters. So this was only for our first lecture. Let us stop here. We'll continue with the same slide in the next lecture, and we'll try to analyze by which relation these equations can be derived, and we'll continue with the further part of our syllabus. Thank you.